Hello, St. Albert the Great families, and especially all my little friends from Children's Liturgy of the Word. This week, it's February 14th, the sixth Sunday in Ordinary Time. And as I look at the time, I think it's almost been a year since the last time I saw you, and we were able to get together and enjoy and celebrate Children's Liturgy of the Word in front of one another. So just know that on this February 14th, which is Valentine's Day, I'm sending you all my love and all my hugs, because I miss you all very, very much. You'll notice that this week, our reading is going to be about Jesus healing the leper. A leper is a person who had a disease, and during their time, many people were afraid of them. Many people did not want to be near them for fear of catching what they had. And oftentimes, we know in this day and age, we're very afraid to catch something that somebody else has, whether it be a cold or chicken pox or even something as bad as COVID-19, which has kept us apart for such a long period of time. COVID is a little bit like what lepers experienced during Jesus's time. Before we begin and hear our gospel today, as always, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let's open our minds, open our eyes, and open our hearts to hear God's message today.
Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear your voice. Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear. Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love like you. Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord. A man with leprosy came to Jesus and kneeled down. He begged, "You have the power to make me well, if only you wanted to." Jesus felt sorry for the man, so he put his hand on him and said, "I want to. Now you are well." At once the man's leprosy disappeared, and he was well. After Jesus strictly warned the man, he sent him on his way. He said, "Don't tell anyone about this. Just go and show the priest that you are well. Then take a gift to the temple as Moses commanded, and everyone will know that you have been healed." The man talked about it so much and told so many people that Jesus could no longer go openly into a town. He had to stay away from the towns, but people still came to him from everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When I was listening to this gospel and preparing for today, I thought an awful lot about the time that we're living in. This time of COVID-19, where we've been separated for so long. And I thought about these poor lepers that Jesus dealt with during his time. During Jesus' time, other people would have told the leper to go away. But what did Jesus say? Think about that. Jesus felt sorry for the man and told him that he wanted to help him. Other people would not have let the leper come near them. But what did Jesus do? He went close to the leper and actually put his hands on him and told him that he was well. Put yourself in that leper's shoes. How do you suppose he felt when other people ran away from him? It probably hurt very deeply, and he probably felt very sad. During Jesus' time, most people who had leprosy or were considered lepers could not live in a town. They couldn't live with the other people. They had to be separated and isolated away from others. Very much like people today who develop COVID-19, they have to stay isolated and sheltered and away from others. But thankfully, with the help of healthcare workers, and hopefully with the help of prayer and Jesus on their side, they're able to get well and they're able to return to their families and their friends. Unfortunately, lepers weren't able to do those kinds of things. And our leper in our story today, he was so blessed and so thrilled by the fact that Jesus healed him that he couldn't keep that message to himself. Even though Jesus said, don't tell anybody, just give your offering to the temple, to the priest there, and then everyone will know you're healed. He couldn't contain his excitement and his happiness over the blessing that he received from Jesus for being healed. So instead of being a leper for the rest of his life, he was able to now be healed. And his most important message that he shared by the way he looked and by the way he sounded and by sharing his message with everyone, he was able to say thank you to Jesus. And all the people that heard his message wanted to be with Jesus, wanted to feel his presence, wanted to feel all the good things that being a part of Jesus' life could do for them. That's what we need to get out of this message today. That no matter what, Jesus always wants to help us. Jesus always wants to make us better. Jesus will always love us no matter what, just like the leper in our story. And no matter how different people may be in our lives, no matter what they look like, what they sound like, what religion they are, what color they are, whether they're a boy or a girl, short or tall, if they wear glasses, if they don't wear glasses, if they wear braces, all of these things that you'll come across in your lifetime, the most important message that we need to learn that we saw Jesus do is to treat everyone like a VIP or a very important person, because that's what Jesus will always do for all of us, and that's what we need to do for others. So as you go out, my friends, and go, maybe some of you are going to school or seeing your families or seeing your friends, make sure we take this message today and we treat everybody like a VIP, like Jesus would, because everybody's important, and know that you are all very important to me, and I look forward to being able to see you sometime soon.